I feel like I've come home to Islip, and I'm very happy, privileged, and honored to have the opportunity to have a part in representing the Brentwood community. When I was in the legislature, Brentwood was part of my legislative district, and we managed to get some really good things done, like the health and wellness building at the Michael Grant campus, which at the time was not the Grant campus, and that was a very proud day for the Brentwood community when that was renamed in Mr. Grant's honor, because he was so instrumental in making sure that that happened to this community. It's so funny to be here at a Brentwood Chamber event that is so well attended, because I remember working with Mike Grant. Did I see Mike come in? Where is he? Working with him going back 22 years ago when he was struggling to keep the chamber alive, when there were two or three people who would show up, he being one of them, me being the other, at an 8 o'clock breakfast meeting. And here you've come so far, and it really is wonderful to see. So what are we going to do for the Brentwood community? What are our plans? Well, my plan, our plan, is our. All of us working together. That's how the Brentwood community is going to be all it can be. We cannot perpetuate this feeling of divide, that it's us against the world. We need to work together. I just came from the Central Islip Civic Council Good Neighbor Luncheon, and I think we can take a lesson from Central Islip. That Civic Council has been around for 49 years, and they can look back with pride on a lot of the initiatives that they have accomplished over the years. And it's with this quiet, kind of everybody pulling together, working together, and getting things done. The time for finger pointing, name calling, trying to be accusatory has got to be put behind us. We have got to work together. That's the only way it's going to happen. I am very, very much hands-on. I try not to be a micromanager, though, and was at an event at Ross Park and saw some of the issues that we're facing in the community. Yesterday and the day before, Parks was in there pulling out the overgrowth and some of the trees that are in there to enable us to have a sight of vision into the park, because it's not a secret. There are bad things happening in Ross Park, and I, for one, want to lead the charge to take that park back. It's our park. It belongs to our community, and we all got to bring it back working together. And I ask for your support to do so. Thank you.
Thank you, Jay. Thank you, members of the Brentwood Chamber. As you know, I am also a member of the Chamber. It's going to be hard for a lawyer to stay within 3 minutes, but I'm going to try. I'm an Islip Rotarian. I am a Riley Eldridge Rotary Youth Leadership Director, and I'm also a volunteer fireman. Just about 10 or 12 years ago, I saw there was a real need in this community for Spanish-speaking fraternities. I decided at that point I'm going to learn Spanish, and I did. But half of my client base at this point in time is from the Brentwood area. I am very sensitive to their needs. I'm very sensitive to the things that I've seen occurred over the years, and to the perceived injustices that exist in this community. One of the main things we'd start off with, hopefully, would be to get a home office up here for constituent services. We have an office now, but I believe it's only open 2 days a week, 2 hours each day. It's not sufficient. We need to have a permanent base in the Brentwood area so that residents can come up and either voice an opinion about their zoning, about their zombie homes that may exist, or about what to do to get STAR, or if they have any applications, how to legalize an owner-occupied two-family. Right now, they have to go down to the main office on Main Street. It's just not fair to not have an office up here. The other thing I'd like to explore is to replace the at-large method of selecting councilmen, to have councilmen selected from different areas. It's something I know has been proposed before, and I know it's been defeated before, but I think it's right to explore this at this stage in time, especially in light of what's been going on in the town of Islip. The park issue is something that should never have happened in the first place. We all know that. People fell asleep at the wheel, and the perception that it's being cleaned up is nice, but the reality is we have strict liability. We don't know what the end is. because New York imposes strict liability on the owner of a property. I have clients, I have friends, I have family that live near this park that have complained to the town in the past. One of them complained about trucks going in all night. There was no answer. Nobody was able to give them an adequate answer. I was at a house a few days ago, and a woman called me back in, knocking on doors, and she says, "Can I talk to you, Tom?" She started crying. She had a son who was awarded a house on Veterans Way, and they had to leave that house. She was in tears. She had me in tears. The perception of injustice exists. Whether or not it's true, it's not the truth that matters a lot of times. It's the perception of the truth. Zoning is not applied evenly throughout this town. It's just not the enforcement of the code. People looking to open up businesses have a difficult time navigating the morass of and the bureaucracy and the paperwork that they need in order to open up a business. It takes way too long to open up a business in this town. It takes way too long to get a development going. And that's my 30 seconds. I'm up. Thank you.